In class 11, business studies, we are on chapter 4, business services. And in previous classes, I explained you about nature and feature of services, difference between services and goods, types of services. Then also I explained you about banks, functions of banks, e-banking. Now today we are going to start insurance. And today's topic is insurance. Am I audible, Mayur? Yes. Now insurance, as you know, in common terms, insurance means protection against risk, uncertainties, mishappenings. So protection provided by insurance company to insured by charging some amount as premium. Like you can get insurance of your vehicle, life, goods. Nowadays anything can be insured. Okay, so that will be like vehicle, life insurance and other things. So today I am going to explain you about the insurance, principles of insurance, terms regarding insurance, and insurance provides us protection. See, insurance, you can see the slide. Mayur, you visible properly? Is it visible? Yes. Insurance is an agreement between two parties whereby one party undertakes in exchange for a consideration to pay to the other party on agreed sum of money to compensate the loss, damage or injury caused as a result of some unforeseen events. Achil, please note down. Achil Jain, this is the definition of insurance. It is an agreement which minimizes the risk factor, which compensates the loss, damage or injury caused as a result of some unforeseen events. Unforeseen means unpredictable event. As you know, future is uncertain. We cannot predict about the future, but by taking insurance we can share the risk, we can minimize the risk factor, or insurance company will compensate at the time of loss, damage, injury or some mishappening. That time insurance company will compensate. This is insurance. Okay, in India the insurance are of various types. You can get the facilities of insurance company like life insurance, fire insurance, marine insurance. Various types of insurance facilities are available by public sector as well as private sector. Government given the permission to private sector for insurance facilities as well as public sector like Jeevan Bima Nigam, Life Insurance Corporation is working under public sector units, as I explain you in the chapter number 3. Okay, now important terms. In this, you can underline this term. This is agreement, okay? Compensate, what the compensate insurance company will cover? Loss, damage or injury, okay? Now, important terms in this chapter. Who is insurer? Who is insurer? Insurer is one who promised to indemnify another on the happening of the event mentioned in the contract. See, my dear children, insurer is one who promised to pay. Like in simple words, we can say insurance company is insurer because insurance company is insurer who promised to pay the compensation claim on the happening of any event. Then insured, the person who will be indemnified on the happening of a specified event, like the common people who takes insurance policy, we take insurance policy, we are insured because we will be indemnified on the happening of a specified event. Then what is premium? The consideration paid by the insured to the insurer is known as premium. My dear children, I told you, for business services, you can talk to your parents. They will give you the guideline also. They will explain you. They know better than us, better than you. So your, with your parents, you should discuss. They have taken insurance policy, must. They have taken insurance policy for the vehicle, for the godown, for their life. Then talk to them. When we buy the vehicle, we generally insured it. Generally, businessmen insured the property also, building also. So talk to them. And talk these terms with them also. Like what is the premium? How they are paying? Okay, premium is the consideration paid by the insured to the insurer, which is known as premium. Now, policy. Policy means the documents containing the terms and conditions. What is the policy? Policy means the document which contains the terms and conditions of a contract of insurance. Then what is risk? Risk is the uncertain event or happening. Mishappening in case of life insurance policy, accidental insurance policy, fire. The risk which is uncertain. No one can predict. Like this corona pandemic, no one can predict. Same risk is everywhere, but we cannot eliminate the risk. We can minimize it. Be careful. Listen. We cannot eliminate the risk factor. We can minimize it by taking precautions, by taking insurance policies. So insurance policy will cover the loss, will help at the time of mishappening. I'm sure you must understand it. See, corona, like corona, is the risk. We cannot eliminate it, but we can minimize it by taking precautions. Same here. Insurance company is not going to give you the guarantee of eliminating elimination of risk. They will share your loss at the time of mishappening, uncertain event. Okay. Then what is subject matter? The person or property which is insured against a particular risk. Like I get my car insured, then car is a subject matter. Subject matter. You can discuss these terms with your parents. Now, I'm sure you must understand this one. Insurer, who promises. Insured, who is taking insurance policy. Premium, the amount, maybe 3 monthly, 6 monthly, or annually. It depends on the choice or the terms and conditions. Then policy, it's the document which contains the terms and conditions. This is the policy. Then risk, risk is an uncertain event, mishappening. Okay, then subject matter, the person or property which is insured against a particular risk. Like we always take insurance of our vehicle. In that case, vehicle is subject matter. Nowadays, the costly cell phones are being insured also. That is the subject matter. Now, my dear children, these are the principles of insurance. See, many times we can see the insurance company is not giving claim, not giving compensation claim. Then people can oppose it. Then insurance company can say that they are following some principles, like first is utmost good faith. Utmost good faith is based on French term, that is uberemae fidei, means the based on mutual trust and confidence between insurer and insured. It means they must disclose. They must disclose all the material facts, all the related information. Up to here, you will write all material facts. This is the term I want to say, all the material facts. Listen carefully. Utmost good faith means the insurer and insured should show each other good faith. They should disclose all the facts, all the information correctly. The insurance company should not do any cheating or fraud. They should say every terms and condition on the prior basis. See, when you see the advertisement on the TV, sometimes we see the last line, they speak in very fast way. Terms and conditions applied. This is terms and condition applied should be disclosed from the both point of view. Like insurance company will explain all the terms and conditions, as well as insured will also explain all the correct information. Like if I am getting, listen please, I am giving you example. If I, listen please, Priyanshi, one example I am going to give, Rishiraj, that is very useful. One person is a thief. He has stolen a car of someone and got it insured. This car also taken by someone, some other thief, that is also stolen by someone. Now this person approached to the insurance company and tell them, please give me the insurance claim. Insurance company will not compensate. Why? What is the reason behind that? The reason behind that, the insured not disclosed all the correct information. He did not disclose them that this car is someone else and he has stolen it. Same here. One more example, Priyanshi, that question I gave last year, that one person has cancer and he has taken insurance policy without disclosing in his medical report that he has cancer or heart disease or AIDS, whatever it is. Then he died due to this disease within 3 months. Do you think insurance company will compensate? No. Why? They will give that the principle of utmost good faith is not following. My dear children, this principle should be followed by both sides, insurance company as well insured. We should not hide any information with them. We should disclose everything with the related of that vehicle, that life, that matter. And insurance company should also clear all the terms and conditions. Like you know about it, that insurance company did not make the claims, those who died in a flood or in Kedarnath, natural calamity, that is according to their terms and conditions. Okay, because they have not got the dead bodies. So many reasons are there, many information is there which should be disclosed to each other. The next is insurable interest. Insurable interest means the person is said to have an insurable interest when he stands to gain from the existence of the subject matter insured and would suffer a financial loss with its destruction. Yathat Kumar, today you will talk to your dad that he has taken insurance policy or not. Okay, then afterwards when we will revise it, then we will discuss. See, we can take insurance to only those things which are belonging to us, which are under the ownership of us. I cannot take the insurance policy of Anuj Sharma because my insurable interest is not lies here. I can take insurance policy of myself, my daughters. Okay, because according to insurance company, there should be insurable interest lies in it. Himang copied it. Like, I want to give you one more example. I like the car of Mukesh Ambani, but I cannot take the insurance of his car. Okay, because why? Insurable interest is not there. That car is his, not mine. I can take insurance of my small car, quid, that is mine. My insurable interest lies in that. Okay, if that car damaged, I will destruct, then I will have financial loss. Got it or not? We can take the insurance of only those things. Got it? Like, I want to tell you, everyone must know about Ronaldo. Who knows about Ronaldo? Yes, Imang, very good. He got insured his legs. Got it? Another example. Great singer, Lata Mangeshkar, you all know about her. She has got insured her throat. Why we can take insurance of ourselves, our belongings, because in that case, financial loss will be there if it destroys. I cannot take the insurance of Imam I cannot take the insurance of this building, beautiful building. No, I can take insurance of my little flat. I can take insurance policy of my small car only. I can take insurance of only to those who are belong to me. Got it, Mayur? Then indemnity. Indemnity. All contracts of insurance except life, accident, sickness are contracts of indemnity. According to this principle, the insured is entitled to recover an amount of actual loss or insured sum, whichever is less. Whichever is less. This is the main point which we can say. I will give you example first. You should note down. Indemnity. I will give you example. Wait. We can recover an amount of actual loss or insured sum, whichever is less. But this principle is not applicable on life insurance policy. Yes. Now the question is, Priyanshu, listen beta. Indemnity principle is not applicable on life insurance policy. Noel John. Indemnity principle is not applicable on life insurance policy. Anand Singhvi, how we can say it? Because, simple reason. Because we cannot measure the value of life in terms of money. We cannot value, but here, vehicle damage. You can measure the loss in terms of money. If fire occurred, you can measure the loss in terms of money. But in case of life, you cannot measure the loss in terms of money. Like in your eyes, in your opinion, I don't have any monetary value. But in the eyes of my daughters, I have value which is not measurable in terms of money. So that's why indemnity principle is not applicable on life insurance policy. Because we cannot measure the actual loss in terms of life. Okay, so today we discussed all these three principles. I am going to explain you then. We discuss these terms, insurance meaning, and these terms which we already discussed. These are the principles. We will continue in the next video. Good faith means Viramaya Fidei. They should have mutual trust, insurable interest. We should have some relation with them. Indemnity means we cannot make the profit out of it. Actual loss or insured sum, whichever is less, insurance company is liable to pay that. Now I am going to explain you these three with the example. We have done these three. Utmost good faith. See, every principal has different story. Every principal has different terms and conditions. Utmost good faith means insurance company and insured person must disclose each and every related information. They should not hide anything. Insurance company should disclose everything and insured also should disclose everything. Every related information. Then insurable interest. We can take the insurance only to those which are belonging to us, which are in our relationship, which are in our ownership. By that, we should have some relations. Then indemnity. Indemnity means you cannot make the profits from the insurance company. Insurance company will compensate only the amount which is insured or the actual loss, whichever is less. Like your vehicle insured by 1 lakh rupees, okay, and the damage is of only 40,000 rupees, then insurance company will compensate only 40,000 rupees, not more than it. It means in the indemnity you cannot make the profit. But my dear children, indemnity principle is not applicable on life insurance policy. Insurance policy will pay you the full claim at the time of life insurance policy or at the time of death. I'm sure you all must understood today's topic.